Hello there, Kim, back in the Spellbinder studio. Excited to film a bonus video for you for Glimmer Bootcamp. This is a fun one. This is actually something that is a little twist on the Glimmer because this is a different material than paper. Today we're going to glimmer on satin ribbon. So, to glimmer on satin ribbon, all you need is a really high quality satin ribbon. This happens to be one of the Fun Stampers Journey ribbons, and we have these in quite a few different colors. This particular satin ribbon is shiny on one side and it's got a little bit duller side on the other. But if you have a double faced satin ribbon, it should work just fine. Now I've also got one of our newer sentiments. This is our Essential Glimmer Sentiments. And I grabbed this one because it has a lot of long, narrow sentiments. Now you can also use this technique with designs or background glimmer plates or whatever you want. But I thought, you know what? Maybe the technique would show up really cool with a sentiment. Fun and easy to read. So I'm going to cut just a pretty narrow little slice of my gold foil here. I'm going to do happy birthday. I'm also going to want to trim my foil to the right length because I want to tape it in place. I'm just going to trim a little bit off there. That looks pretty good. Now, of course, I want my foiling to be on the pretty shiny side. And I also want happy birthday to kind of read this direction. In other words, if I wrap up my package, I want my happy birthday to be read this way as my ribbon dangles down. I'm gonna put my glimmer down where I want. I'll leave a little bit of a tail there. Put my plate down. Now, once again, just rule of thumb, you always want to remember to put your shiny side to the most detailed part of your glimmer plate, as I've done here. Now my biggest trick, which is why I trimmed it short, is going to be just to try to center the happy birthday words as much as I can. So I'm going from the glimmer plate across the foil and all the way to my ribbon. This is going to give me the best chance of getting my sentiment on there straight. Of course, I had to use something tricky. If you were using something that was just like a floral or one of our darling borders for glimmer, you wouldn't have to worry so much about, you know, the getting it straight part. Now I'm also going to lay my ribbon with my ribbon tail coming down the long ways, because obviously as I run it through my machine, I'm not going to want to try to stuff this whole roll through my die cutting machine. Just lay it aside. So I also have prepared just a regular cardstock shim. Because this ribbon is so thin, and as I experimented a couple times with it, I found that just a singular cardstock shim works perfectly. And it's also going to kind of help protect my ribbon and maybe this excess foil from getting on my plate. So I'll just go ahead and kind of put that on, hit the timer button, and as soon as it's green, we will run that through our die cutting machine. Okay, see my light is solid green now. Add the glimmer platform to my machine. And again, with that single cardstock shim, I'm going to put my two regular shims on top. I should say my shim and my spacer pad. And then just roll it nice and slow so that sentiment can press right into my ribbon. And then I'm going to go ahead and bring it back out because, again, I've got my ribbon roll here and I don't want to have to thread it through. If I knew exactly the length I wanted to cut, you know, you could go ahead and cut your ribbon, but just kind of a extra long piece here. Now again, our best ever craft tape really does well with this satin ribbon. I think y'all are going to have to kind of experiment with different ribbons, you know, whether it's something you have in your stash or, you know, experiment with something you have hanging around, but I'm telling you guys, seriously, look how absolutely sweet that is. Just foiled beautifully on there. Of course, this is a nice bold sentiment, so it stands out really well. But can you imagine how special that is to add that to your ribbon? Your gift wrap or a little bow on a gift bag or whatever you can think of. Now you guys will chuckle because I actually did add mine to a gift box and you'll see why I put my words going this way, because first time I glimmered this particular color ribbon, which I wanted to use, I actually had it going the other way. In other words, I kind of felt like it was upside down, but maybe it's not upside down. I don't know. You guys will have to tell me. It is kind of cute this way. You can read it, you know, going up your ribbon. But I thought this actually seemed a little bit more natural to have the words starting at the top. So just keep in mind which end of the ribbon you're going to do, because your sentiment will be going one way or the other. But I thought it was really fun. I can't wait to experiment with this, maybe for some holiday greetings or doing some, you know, trying some different color ribbons, some different widths. I just can't wait to experiment some more. So I hope you love this bonus technique and that you will give it a try soon. And definitely report your results back to us and let us know how it goes.